Hi, I'm Dan Smigrod, founder of the We Get Around Network Forum. Today is Friday, June 1, 2018, and I'm at the 2018 Google Street View Summit in San Francisco. And joining me is Neil with NC Tech, and you're the co-founder.
Co-founder.
And you were on stage yesterday at Google, and you made a very exciting announcement.
We announced the new iStar Pulsar camera system. We don't refer to it actually in any of our data as a camera. We refer to it as a big data system because it's connected from edge to cloud. It has a full cloud backend processing. So it's not like a traditional camera where you're going to have some imagery that you can work with on your local computer. You create so much data, you really need backend cloud data infrastructure.
So this data capture camera, both together, is really awesome. Now I'm going to assume that you're going to watch every video and be all over the nctech.com. nctechimaging.com website to check out all the specs. What we're going to do today for the We Get Around Network Forum community is talk about how to make money with this, why you want to buy one. I am super excited about this NC Tech iStar Pulsar. And so, Neil, how do we make money?
Well, the camera itself, we released there's a launch price, $2,995 for Google Street View certified photographer.
So this is $3,000 US if you're a Google certified Street View photographer.
Yeah.
So it's like nothing.
Correct. And on our website, there's some details there also about some of our previous customers who have our Iris 360 camera. There's some information about those users there. If you had an Iris 360 camera, you can look at our website. There's some offers there for you guys where we want to reward you for, if this is another product that you're looking at. So, how you would make money with this camera? It's really a simple case of we tried to take the workflow of creating huge volumes of data and making it as simple as just clicking an app button, and then you don't have to worry about the camera, you don't have to call yourself a photographer even. We have this this term that we're using, which is called a virtualizer, where we're asking everyone to virtualize their world.
Okay, so you're a virtualizer pro.
Yeah.
And let's take just the use case of Google Street View. There's 80 different capture devices to publish to Google Street View. Why would I want this device? What kind of jobs that this is ideal for?
So really, it's just like any of the current services that trusted photographers already do, where they're potentially, they have a client who wants an indoor space captured. This camera is similar in that sense, where you have a client who may want an outdoor space captured. So it could be a university, it could be an oil rig, it could be, any location on the planet, effectively, whether it's vehicle mounted on a vehicle, a car, or you can mount this on a trekker.
So a trekker would be, I'd go put the camera in a backpack and it would sit right above my head, and then I could go walk the space.
And there's no extra hardware. This is the entire product here. You do not need a computer. There is no computer. All you need is your phone to use our app.
So you can use your phone to run the iStar Pulse, the NC Tech iStar Pulsar, and then you just need to be close to a high-speed Wi-Fi.
That's right. So when you're out capturing, you don't need anything other than the camera and a device to control the camera.
Okay.
And so you can trek in the Grand Canyon, you can be on Mount Everest. It doesn't matter where you are, and we have an external battery pack.
So I know it's exciting to go up Mount Everest, but I know where we get around network forum communities are saying, hey, you're asking me for $3,000, the backpack probably costs some extra money, the car mount probably adds some extra money. So, I'm willing to say to buy this, but help me understand what can I do today. So I think certainly the first use here we are at Google Street View Summit is to say, if you have 100,000 square feet and it's inside and outside, this is the kind of capture camera is going to make the capture easy, fast, and simple.
Absolutely. It's the highest resolution camera on the market today. So your data is going to be the best data on out there. It's comparable with Google's own Street View cars, that kind of resolution. And the information that's in that that data. It's going to be fantastic for the client that your pro photographer is doing that capture for. So when they upload that information, whether it's an indoor shopping mall or it is a park or a highway or a road network for a government, for example, or say it was a city planner where you're going to tour the entire city. This product captures so much data so fast. It's not just a product for capturing a single property or a street. You can do an entire city with this product. With one camera, you can do an entire country.
So maybe you live at the beach, or maybe you live in a historic district, maybe you live someplace where the Google Street View photography either doesn't exist or is dated. So this is an opportunity to map not only the streets to have current street view photography, but also to be able to go inside of business. And as I understand it, this NC Tech iStar Plus Art can capture 7 frames a second, and that means that you can either walk the space or that you could be driving 60 miles an hour, and it's going to capture this magic there of how it does its capture so that you can use large spaces. So if you're a We Get Around Network Forum community member and you're trying to think about, okay, I've heard about this NC Tech iStar Pulsar, and I've told you that it's super exciting, and so you're researching it. So, in fact, one of our members reached out to us. They're in Aruba, and the challenge in Aruba is there's no Google Street View photography at all. And so, why don't you pick it up from there? How does that magically end up on Google?
So the way that the platform works, as I say, you capture. You don't need any devices. Once you've captured, you bring the product back to a location that has a Wi-Fi connection. The camera will connect to that Wi-Fi, and then the camera will directly push that data up to NC Tech's VR World servers. So this is a new platform that we've announced, VR.World.
Okay, VR.World. Is a new platform from NC Tech, and I presume it's an open platform as well, so it's not even just NC Tech devices. We need a platform for hosting.
We're hardware agnostic with that platform.
Okay, so if I get it to VR.World, then I hit a button and I publish to Google Street View.
Well, it's even easier than that. You don't need to go to the website.
You don't even need to go there.
That is there, and we'll be turning that website live very soon. Before this launch, this camera is going in through a very secure connection to that platform. So when you take the product back, it's connected to the Wi-Fi. There's a switch on here where you can literally. There's a little switch just here. By pushing that switch, the camera will automatically start transmitting your whole capture that's on the device. There's a solid state hard disk internally. All that information will be pushed up to the cloud, and then it'll be processed, and then it'll let you review the information. Once it's processed, you can see it on a preview video. You'll be able to look through your route. The routes are very large, could be long, and they could be very large. So the best way to view those routes is a video. Okay. So you look through the video.
Okay.
You can then trim the video to make sure that you remove anything that you don't want as part of that clip, and then you can publish. When you hit publish, it's publishing from cloud to cloud, from our cloud straight to Google, so it's an instant thing.
That's crazy. So once it's in the VR World cloud, and you're ready to publish to Google Street View, it just goes cloud to cloud.
It's literally hours, and it's going through Google.
So for our We Get Around Network Forum member who's in Aruba, does he need to talk to Google to say, hey, there is no Google Street View photography, what do I need to do in order to publish to Google Street View? Or is it simply, as long as I use the NC Tech iStar Pulsar, upload it to VR World, and then hit the button to say approve, it'll now immediately go to Google Street View?
Start adding publishing to Google. If there is an issue with any kind of new unrooted territories, obviously contact us and we will help and assist and make sure that gets published. And we work very closely with Google, so we'll be able to work our way through that. But I'm sure it'll be a case of just publish and the route will appear.
Okay, so we're talking about a device that was developed in conjunction with Google, so presumably the deep integration is...
There's been a collaborative effort to make sure the workflow is very seamless. This product has been a 2-year development, funded and developed by NC Tech. We've had a lot of assistance with Intel and collaborative efforts. And there's a lot of Intel technology that we've leveraged inside here, and we've worked closely with Sony on new sensors, and we've had to develop new driver technologies with these companies to make this product possible. So it's a collaborative effort with Sony, Intel, and Google to get to where we are.
So let me see if I can just call a couple highlights. So if you're already a Google Street View photographer and you want to kick it up on steroids to do super large spaces, indoors, outdoors,
this
lets you go indoors, outdoors, large spaces, capturing a huge amount of data and make it super easy to upload and publish to Google Street View. And so if you've ever, I mean, we as photographers, we think about workflow all the time and how sometimes we get bogged down in the workflow. I want to say you gave a lot of thought to that to say, how do we cut out all the steps in the workflow to just make it easy to publish? Neil, so NC Tech, iStar, Pulsar, you announced this on stage here at the 2008 Google Street View Summit here in San Francisco. When can I start placing an order?
You can place pre-orders now, as from yesterday. On there is no money taking. It's just a case of it adds you to the queue. We have stock of these cameras today, so once we plan on shipping in mid-June, so June the 15th is the date that we expect.
That's June 15th, 2018.
Yeah. So place your pre-order. When we are ready to ship your product, we contact you and say, okay, it's time to, you know, to transfer the funds. At that point, the shipment will be shipped to you. So we have stock. It's not something that we say, you know, it's 2 months, 3 months, 4 months. We have these cameras. We've been collecting. It's been years of development. We've held off. We didn't bring out our Iris Pro camera because we knew this product was coming, and we didn't want to have a product and then for those customers to say, oh, well, you just brought something else. So we just made the decision. It was a hard decision to make. We invested a lot of time and effort in Iris Pro, but we felt it was the right move to just stop that product and to focus on this, and I think this will be the right product for everyone.
Yeah, so this is super exciting. I've looked at a lot of cameras. I've looked at a lot of data collectors. That are also cameras. I am super excited about the NC Tech iStar Pulsar. I would suggest go figure out, you know, go check out all the stats about the camera. It's nctechimaging.com. I saw the NC Tech team present at the 2018 Google Street View Summit in Tokyo in May of 2017 when they first talked about the camera. So this is actually the kind of the camera is oh so close to shipping. Forgive me, I say camera, but it's really that much more. It's a virtualizer.
It's a big data capture platform.
It's a big data capture platform. And so if you've been watching, if you stayed with us this long, go check out nctechimaging.com. Check out all the specs that might matter to you. But I'm telling you, this is a transformational camera that will enable you to make lots of money shooting large spaces indoors and outdoors. And to be able to publish to Google Street View. It's very exciting. Neil, thank you for visiting. Really appreciate it. I've been visiting with Neil, co-founder of NC Tech. I'm Dan Smigrod, founder of the We Get Around Network Forum from San Francisco. Thanks for tuning in. We appreciate it. Thanks again, Neil.
Thank you. Thanks, Dan.
Thank you for taking the time to visit.
And we're